și ale lipsa de motivare pe care foarte mulți
angajați.
The Race Card Project was set up 3 years ago to challenge racism and other social justice inequalities by using mainstream and grassroots media along with social media. The focus was on 4 areas in the West Yorkshire area, Bradford, Huddersfield, Leeds and Wakefield, concentrating on education and training, police and community, health and well-being, of settled communities from the African Caribbean and new migrating African communities. Two key things I wanted to get out of the conference: more collaboration with African and African Caribbean groups across Yorkshire. That was the first thing, very important for me. Second thing, to build bridges with the African migrating new community that is now coming to the region, so we have a collective voice.
When we look at all those socio-economic indicators in education, in employment, we're at the bottom of the list, even though we fight, even though we struggle, but we've got to do that again and again and again. That's why I'm here in Leeds, to really want to help inspire a new generation of activists, young and old, to be strong, to be better connected.
That's why it's important. It's important that we start sitting down together and making sure the right people are representing us.
I have a really key role is in overseeing investigations that we carry out. The IPCC carries out independent and managed investigations, and we also carry out appeals work as well. And it's my responsibility as a commissioner to oversee those investigations. So things like setting the terms of reference, that's a really important part of an investigation, because it determines what you investigate and also what you don't investigate. So that's really, really important. Our investigators will actually do the investigative work, but it's my responsibility to scrutinise their work, you know, to ask them questions, you know, to find out why they make particular decisions throughout an investigation.
We live in a world where data is the power, and sometimes people want to come to us and get our data from us. Many of you will have worked with local authority, for example. They want your data, but they never want to give you any data, because then it becomes, when you ask them for data, it becomes a data protection situation. But whenever we give them data, you know, so it is an important thing, you know, data protection, or we protecting or holding the data for ourselves.
You can't talk about race inequality when if it holds us back, if there's a penalty for no other reason for getting a job than the color of your skin or the African name that you have, then that's a race penalty. And you have to show anyone that is subject to holding people back the race card and say, I will show it to you. Whilst the color of my skin is a barrier for my success, for society's success, I will show you the race card.
Not a single one of those cases was upheld by the police. Not a single one. Every single one, it said, we don't believe you. And you know, there is a slight chance, a very slight, thin, minute chance that they were right to have not upheld a single case. Show us the evidence. Tell us why you came to that outcome.
In short, it's because of racial discrimination. There ought to be representative democracy, but there isn't. And we know over centuries, in fact, that we've been locked out from jobs, locked out from political office. And our default position has had to be to fight.
The growth rate for black organisations is much harder. And it comes from both sides. It's from our own community as well, that don't want to see us develop, and the issues that go with that, as well as the statutory organisations. So it's about talking and discussing with each other what the issues are, what are the problems that you have, and why do you not want us to move forward, and let's work together to discuss and move forward.
Over the last 3 years I've been working on Race Card, and my key findings are that the older generation are not really handing over the baton to the next generation.
For the length of time we as black people been here, and in this I have to include myself, we let down ourselves. Big time, big time.
But I know a change gonna come.
The black community's accessing and use of social media is minimal. It's very at the bottom of their agenda.
Just by way of example of how much reach you can get in terms of social media, Mark Duggan shooting, obviously it's not necessarily an investigation where there are positive opinions of how we engaged, communicated at the beginning of it, but just by way of example, when we got the forensic ballistics information back about the non-police firearm that was found at the scene, and we had the information that it hadn't been fired, we put a tweet out on that at, I think, because I was in the office at that stage, and it was about 6:30 in the evening. Within, I think it was in about 15 minutes, we'd had more than 5,000 retweets of that, and we'd reached more than, potentially reached, more than 500,000 people in 15 minutes.
Wow. Wow.
The poor old public sector laptop that I was monitoring it on could not cope. TweetDeck was just, for anybody who uses TweetDeck will know that rep. It was phenomenal. And that was the first time, that was, when was Mark, it was 2011. That was the first time I really truly understood the power to kind of, the power of social media to reach that kind of level of people.
I think there are some voluntary sector organisations, including BME voluntary sector organisations, that don't understand the power of social media. That's why this event is so important, because I think it is absolutely key to engaging with people. It's the future.
We're not celebrating our successes enough. We're constantly looking at and listening to the negatives about us and thinking we've got to fight them, instead of using what we're doing positively, putting that out there and let that do the work for us.
Well, I think it's right, when you become a leader of any situation, to be lead by example, you've got a psychological expectancy of others, yes, to achieve. But nobody looks at you and say, are you okay, are you breathing well?
Those development workers within the voluntary sector who are of African descent, and you know, our life expectancy is 2/3 shorter than our white counterparts, and that's because we're not sharing amongst ourselves. In my belief is that we're not networking enough, we're carrying our own problems ourselves, and then we have our home lives as well. So to keep our mental health up, we do need to share, we need to have more get-togethers like this, more events like this. And actually, when we were talking in our health and well-being thing, we were saying, how do we continue this on? How do we make sure that we don't lose touch with each other?
You know, we have 4 or 5 years before we get to 2020. Let's see that as a target to tackle race inequality, to ensure that the foundations are laid in local politics, in national politics, in community politics, for us to be fantastically empowered. We have to remain positive, we have to be proactive, but in doing so, you know as well as I do, Milton, we inspire a generation by our own actions.
Our parents left us a half-decent legacy, if we're openly honest. Now, what are we leaving for that next generation, and how are we going to ensure the stories, our stories, are there for them as reference points? That's what's important to me.
Events like these are really important. This event is important, really, really important to us, but I really feel that people who are here, it's also important to them. I think it's just a continuation of the work that we're doing, because it's not the end of the work. There will be an end of work in March when we launch the report. And a media toolkit.
I think the first steps are looking at how far we have come in 50 years and stop worrying about the negativity out there. So I think looking within ourselves as communities and what we've achieved. That's an absolute first.
But today was just a part of that process, because remember, we've been going for about nearly 3 years now. So it's a part of that process which we're coming towards the end of trying to build that community links, those community links. I'm going closer together.
I love when black people come together to be empowered, to serve notice, to give guidance about what we can and what we cannot do to make change. I want everybody that sees this video to get behind Race Card, get behind the West Indian Black Cultural Centre here in Leeds and Huddersfield and beyond, because the whole of the Black Project must be stronger than the sum of its parts.
When they do the right thing.